song for everything. Well, there's a good chance that right now, as you're watching Good Day Atlanta, you're sipping on a cup of coffee. But have you ever tried coffee cupping? And be honest, do you even know what that means? I don't. Good Day Atlanta's Paul Milliken is live at East Pole Coffee Company in Atlanta. You're going to get to try something new today and teach us something too, Paul. Good morning.
Yes. I'm very excited. Elise, by the way, are my pupils totally dilated? I don't know if that happens when you're really caffeinated, but I just feel like it's something that would happen. I'm very wired right now, but I'm very happy too. I love spending the morning at a coffee shop, especially one like East Pole Coffee Company, which is a coffee bar, but it's so much more than that. And it really is your place to learn about coffee. And our professor for the day is the co-founder, co-owner, Jared Carr. Great to see you. How are you?
Good. Not as wired as you, but still good.
Well, you're going to get there, I think, because I'm going to make you drink a lot of coffee. Although, I mean, your life is coffee, and I love the story of this place. So for people who didn't watch last hour, how would you describe what East Pole Coffee Company is? What is this place?
Yeah, we're a roastery here in Atlanta with a coffee bar built around it with a really incredible hospitable staff that pairs hospitality with quality.
Yeah, and the idea here really is to let people know where their coffee comes from. I mean, specifically, what region, what country, and then also how it's made, right?
Yeah, totally. That's why everything is divided by glass so that a customer can come in and see what's going on in the back and maybe never know that coffee was green before they take their espresso to go, you know?
Yeah, there's so much to learn. I mean, I'm one of those people, I think like most people watching, that I take it for granted. I get my coffee, I drink it, I don't ever think about where it came from. When you start to really know coffee, though, can you taste the differences between regions where it comes from?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, especially if you have something like an Ethiopian coffee versus a Colombian coffee. Okay. There's pretty general flavor distinguishing factors there.
Nice. Okay, and a way to do that is by coffee cupping. So I told you, I don't know what's about to happen. I don't know what it is. So first, explain it. What is coffee cupping?
Yeah, so a cupping is just a universal way to taste and evaluate coffees.
Okay.
Right? So it's broken up into three parts. We're going to kind of do a deconstructed cupping here. We're going to smell the coffee. Then we're going to smell the coffee, and then we're going to taste the coffee.
Okay.
Right?
All right.
Cool. So you ready to start?
Let's do it. Let's go with the first step. Right. So first step is?
We're going to smell the coffee dry. And what I like to do here is I like to take the cup, and I like to knock the side just a little bit. That releases some aromatics.
Yep.
And then as long as you're not wearing a lot of lotion on your hands, I would just cover it like this and breathe in.
Huh.
And then be careful not to breathe right back into the cup unless you want to be wearing coffee grounds on your face.
I don't want to do that. So let's try it. Okay. Ooh. I feel like I'm extra caffeinated just from that. I really, that actually kind of like has like a, maybe a floral. Is that, would that be right? Like something like that?
Yeah. So this is a natural process Ethiopian coffee. So the natural process part of that is going to mean in general that you're going to have more fruit forward notes out of that. So floral is a good Ethiopian characteristic as well. So this next part is we've added water to the coffee.
Okay.
And so it's currently brewing. And what you're going to do is you're going to smell it again. And sometimes the flavor will change. You'll perceive different notes.
Okay.
And so I'm going to demonstrate how we're going to smell it this time.
Okay, go for it. Let's see. All right. I think I can handle that. Okay, get right down in it.
One more pro tip for you, Paul.
Yeah.
Don't dip your nose in the boiling lava hot water, okay?
I don't want a burnt nose, so don't worry about it. All right. Ooh, that smells so good.
Right.
I love that.
A little bit,
It's similar, but stronger.
Okay. So
last step,
the most fun step right here is we're going to drink the coffee. And what I always like to say is that we're going to pretend that we're drinking or eating really hot soup. Okay. So we're going to slurp the coffee. That's what we're doing is cupping. That's why we're using a spoon is we're slurping.
Oh, I love this because I'm going to hold the microphone right up to my mouth, Elise, and totally gross you out with the slurping sound.
And so what we're doing is we're spraying the coffee all over our palate so we can get a good idea of what we're tasting here.
Okay.
So it's going to look like this.
Oh, that was, he's good at that. All right, let's see if I can do it too. All right, let's see if I got the slurp.
It was pretty good.
Sorry, that grossed everybody out.
That is classy.
That's a really good coffee.
It's great, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a delicious coffee.
So this is the way it's done all over the world. This is how coffee is evaluated at its most base form. And this is something our viewers can come do every Saturday morning. And it's a much longer, more involved process when they do it, right?
Yeah, it's about an hour long usually.
I love that. All right, very cool. So there we've learned what coffee cupping is, although I mean, my kind of coffee cupping is just taking this whole thing and slurping it in one gulp, which I've been doing all morning and I'll do more of. So when I see you later today, these pupils, they'll be even bigger.
My eyes
will be like this.
I'm going to be bouncing off the walls. Okay, give us one more slurp. Just one more, Paul. One more slurp.
You wanted, all right, they want me to do another, they want okay. another good slurp here. All right, listen, this is going to be better. I want to do it like Jared did, right? Oh, no. I went to the back of my throat, but it's a really good coffee. Yeah,
I'm going to let you practice on that. No more coffee, though, for you today. You're done, Paul.
I'll work
You're
on
done.
It.
Well, East Pole Coffee Company is located at 255 Otley Drive, Suite 105 in Atlanta. Coffee cuppings are offered to the public for free Saturday mornings at 10, but limited to the first 15 people who show up. And coming up tomorrow morning, if you're having some trouble nailing it, a weekend event will help turn your Pinterest fails into big successes. Paul will have a live preview of this year's Pinners Conference happening at Cobb Galleria Center.